Today we will start with a new chapter in history. The second chapter, European powers in India. European powers in India. Page number 15. Turn your books to page number 15. All right. Now, you know, we had been under the British rule, all right, colonial period for approximately 200 years. And now in this particular chapter, we will see that how, you know, all this happened, that how we came under the control of the Britishers. So we will begin with that, what led to these European companies to come and set up their trading centers here. And then why, you know, there were fights among the different European countries who wanted to have trade links with India. And then finally, how English East India Company, they defeated all the rest who were here, and they gained total control over India, over trade also. And then with time, they also took political control over India, and India was turned into a British colony. So all that we will see during the course of this chapter. So let's begin. The first topic here is mercantilism. Now, what is mercantilism? Now, what it basically means, in simple terms, we can say commercialism. Now, again, what it means is that you try to make maximum profit. So this mercantilism, the theory, it basically emphasizes on making maximum profit, as much profit as you can. Now, this mercantilism means making or maximizing profit. Now, this is a political as well as an economic system. Now, since we are talking about profit, so we can say that it could be only an economic system related with trade and business and money. But no, you know, to have that control, it was also related to politics, and that we'll see during the course of a chapter, that how it was related politically also. So it was a political as well as an economic system that arose in the 17th and 18th century. We are talking about the world, and it purports means it appears what it what mercantilism is all about. Now basically what it says, that the economic strength of a country is related to a positive balance of trade. Means if any country has a positive balance of trade, now positive balance of trade here we are talking about imports and exports. So if any country has a positive balance of trade, then the country would be economically secure and strong. Now what they mean to say is that in order to remain economically, means trade wise, money wise, and politically also, means you are able to really rule well and govern a large part, all right, then, and if you want to do both these things successfully, so a country, what they should do, they should export more and import less. Okay, export, import. What is export and what is import? I think this you must be knowing. Yes, class 8?
Yes. Ma'am, a product is imported when we take it from any other country, and the product is exported if we send it to any other country.
Okay, when we send to any other country, then what it is?
Exported.
Export. Alright. And when we buy or take in from any other country? Okay. Alright. So what they said is that if you want to be to have a positive balance of trade, then you need to export more, all right, and import less. Now why? Because you know, when you import, when you buy something, then you need to pay them money, right? So your money is going to someone else. But when you are exporting, then you know they give you money to buy. So then, you know, their money is coming to you. So your wealth is increasing, and that is what they wanted, that there should be more export than imports. And now what they said is that if we have such a positive balance of trade, then according to this mercantilist thought, now it result in having a surplus of gold in the practicing country. So what it means is that if any country will follow this principle of having a positive balance of trade, then you know what happen, we will have more gold reserves in our country. Because basically at that time what happened, you know, like for trades and all, either it was barter system, like I give you something and you give me something in return, but or otherwise, you know, normally gold and silver, they were given to buy things. And so what happens, like if you are exporting more, then you are getting these gold reserves money from outside. All right, so you are increasing your country's wealth, and that is what they wanted. Now 18th century, a very important 18th century Scottish economist Adam Smith, and though you know he was not a supporter, he was not an advocate of mercantilism, now he was responsible, he coined the word, he formed the word mercantile system. Now mercantilism was in opposition, means whatever Adam Smith he proposed, whatever he said, now this mercantilism is just, you can say, the opposite of it. And now Smith, he stood for free trade, that there should be trade should be free business should be there, all right, not much duties and all should be put on the people. And you know, everyone who wants, they should be free to come in for trading, for business and all, and the free movement of people and goods, and means that there may not be many restrictions on the flow and of the movement of goods and people from one place to another. And anyone, you know, any new person who wants to come and be a part of this particular group of trade, or who wants to be a trader or a merchant, so he should be free, or a businessman, so he should be free, and there should not be you know, under the control of the government. That is what he stood. And now one of the key assertions of mercantilism is, but so Smith, he stood for what he stood for, free trade, free enterprise, means trade should be free, businesses should be free, and movement should be free, there should be no restrictions. And basically what we can say is that, in other words, it went against the precepts of a Lazarus fair economy. Now it, what is that Lazarus fair economy? Now basically it is a free market, all right, free market economy, basically a capitalist economy, and this is against government's intervention, means government should not intervene in the trade matters, and it should be a free market trade, all right, and basically a capitalist system. But this mercantilism was basically just the opposite of what Adam Smith proposed. And now one of the, you could say, the key statements, one of the main features of mercantilism is that if you want to increase your country's wealth, your national wealth, so it will come through the, it is wrongly written import, it will come through export, because through import you are giving your money away, so it should be exports. So it will come through exports, and when you accumulate, when you have taken up so much gold and other precious metals as silver, so when you have got, you know through export you have got money, and you have got silver and gold in return, so that way you can increase the wealth of the country, or the national wealth, means in wealth of the nation. And now we are basically studying what mercantilism was or is. Now, to acquire wealth, now if any country wants to make more wealth or bring more wealth to the country, so what they should do? They should export the maximum quality quantity of goods and restrict its imports. So if a country, if any country, they want to increase their national wealth, then what they should do? They should export more goods and import less goods, and the balance of trade must remain favorable and gold reserve will grow. And so what they said, that if you are selling more, all right, sending outside more and bringing in less, then obviously what will happen? The balance of trade, there will be a positive balance of trade, and then your gold reserve, the money in your country, it will grow. Now basically, let's have a look at the advantages of mercantilism. Now what it helps? It helps nations become imperialistic. Now we have already seen imperialism when we were doing the first chapter. So we have seen imperialism and colonialism. You know, it is a process through which imperialism, through which a strong country, it brings a weak country under its political and economic control. So what happens? Mercantilism, it led to imperialism. And why? Because people now, these strong companies, these superpowers of Europe, what they wanted? They wanted growth for their country, and you know, that led them to a search for colonies, bringing countries under their political and economic control. And you know, then what will happen? Like, if you have another country over which you can rule and you are governing, so you know, you are governing also, so you can make rules and regulations, and you have total control over the resources also of that particular colony. And so what will happen? It will help to increase the growth of the home nation and increase trade revenue, because you know, now you have control over that colony's money also. So basically you are growing, the money in your country is growing, all right, and you have control over the other country's revenue also. Imperial nations have increased, and you know, the countries during that time we are talking about, so the imperialist countries, those who had colonies in different parts of the world, you know, they were able to grow more in their home countries. Why? Because now they had control over the resources of the other country also, and it also helped them to fuel or to supply or run a better economy. Because you know, now what you could do, you have control over the country's resources also, you can sell them also, all right, and thereby you can make more money. Or you can sell your things in that country, all right, and you can make more money. So basically both ways, the imperialist countries or the home country, you know, it became rich, the economy became better, whereas the colony, they suffered, the colonies, they suffered. Okay, what are the disadvantages of mercantilism? The colonies that are established, this is what we just I just now told you, that you know, the colonies that were established by the home nation, now they were left underdeveloped, nothing was done for their development, everything was done for the benefit, for the maximizing of profit of the home nation, all right, of the imperialist country, and nothing was done for the colony. So they were left underdeveloped and they were dependent on that particular home nation or the country who were ruling over them. And the need to increase gold supply of the home nation, and because the country who were controlling over them, they wanted to increase their gold income, so they took it from there, so their gold income increased, whereas the gold income or the money of the colonies, it decreased, their resources decreased. And this growth of new colonies and imperialism, you know, for the gold supply, it basically had negative effects on the colonies. So the colonies suffered, as the imperialist nations, you know, they gained control and so the imperialist countries, they became more strong, more powerful, the money in their countries increased, whereas the colonies, you know, they became totally underdeveloped and totally dependent on the home nations or the imperialist countries. Okay, so have you understood mercantilism?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Okay, so for today we will stop here and we'll continue when we meet again.